Welcome to this video. Is my model mesh dependent? How to find the appropriate mesh size for my model? If you have these questions, please keep watching this video. We can use coarse mesh for solving problems, but coarse mesh cannot lead to accurate results. On the other hand, we can use fine mesh, but using very fine mesh can increase our computational cost. Therefore, we should find an appropriate mesh size to have less computational cost and accurate result. For this purpose, we perform mesh dependency study. In fact, we try to find the coarsest mesh which leads to reasonable accuracy. For mesh dependency study, at first we start with coarse mesh and then we refine the mesh and run the problem until we achieve an almost constant results. For result comparison, we usually choose an important output of the model, like displacement or stress, at a special point. Consider modeling of tension in a hole plate. We have solved this problem in our previous video. You can find it in our channel. Now we perform mesh dependency study on this problem. For this purpose, we change the global mesh size and run the problem one more time. Then we read stress at the tip of the hole as the output. We repeat this task several times until we achieve to constant results. For this problem, at first we start with coarse mesh, the mesh size of 2 mm, and calculate the stress at the tip of the hole. The stress is 2.7. Then we reduce the size of mesh by half and calculate the stress one more time. In the next step, we calculate the stress by the mesh size of 0.5, and finally we calculate the stress by mesh size of 0.25. In fact, in each step we reduce the mesh size by half and calculate the stress at the tip of the hole. As we can see from these results, by reducing the mesh size from 2 to 1 mm, we have around 10% change in our result. And in the next step, by reducing the mesh size by half, we have only 4% change. Finally, we have less than 1% change in our results. Usually, changes less than 1% is acceptable for us, and we can conclude that the mesh size of 0.5 is reasonable for this problem. This mesh size can lead to accurate results with reasonable computational cost. There are also different ways to reduce computational cost by variable mesh size. Please watch videos of this playlist which explain how we can create variable mesh size for this problem. Thank you guys for watching this video. If this video has helped you out, please let us know by a like, a comment, or subscribe. See you in next videos.